I want us to go into the preaching of the Word of God, but before that, I want to say Merry Christmas to each and everyone watching and to those who will watch after this recording. And we also wish to see you enjoying the good year that is coming in 2021. May God bless you as we enter into 2021. According to our church, we have declared 2021 to be the year of the fear of the Lord. You can find the scripture in the book of Psalm chapter 34, verse number 9, the year of the fear of the Lord. And today I want to take you back to the gospel of Jesus Christ by preaching a very wonderful message that Jesus has given us. I greet you all once more in the name of Jesus, and I want to welcome you into the preaching of the Word of God. And may God bless you, may God be with you, may God touch your lives, and may God turn you inside out for His good message, that is the gospel of Jesus Christ. I want us to read the book of Matthew, chapter number 28. Matthew, chapter number 28, we read verses 19 and 20. From there we shall skip to the book of Acts, chapter number 1. We shall take only verse number 8. I repeat, Matthew chapter 28, verses 19 and 20. Then we shall read the book of Acts, chapter number 1. Verse number 8 only, I read. I start with the book of Matthew. It says, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost." 20. "Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And look, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world." Amen. These words are coming from the Master himself, Jesus. Now we are reading the book of Acts, chapter number 1. We read verse is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth." May God bless the reading of His word. Shall we pray? Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, I glorify your holy name, that your word shall be preached with power and zest. Father, I pray that our lives may never remain the same. Our spirits may be educated according to your way. Our spirits may be taught who you are, because it is not about us, it's about you. Father, I pray as we celebrate this festive season, we celebrate the coming of Jesus, the message itself, the gospel itself. In the name of Jesus, I praise your holy name that this morning you are amongst us. And Father God, you're going to teach us your way. And I pray that you may speak, suppress all my feelings and all my antics, but you take over and you speak to your people. Speak to the listeners, to the people who are viewing from home. I pray that you speak to the people in front of me also. In the name of Jesus, Father, I bless you and glorify you, because you are God and above you. There is no other God. Take your glory, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I want us to share the word of God on the topic that says the gospel. The gospel. The gospel. The gospel was started on the very first day God created the heavens and the earth, and all the splendor therein. God was actually sending a message that go out and teach people about who I am, And the nice thing about it is, in chapter number 1 of Genesis, when God had created everything, this is what he did. He called a meeting in heaven to announce in heaven that a man is about to be reached. That a person, the image of God, is about to be preached to, is about to be taught the word of God. The gospel did not start the day Jesus came. Jesus came to fulfill what the Father had already started. The gospel had been preached by God himself from the beginning, from the creation. And we now need to understand, how did God preach the gospel? After the creation of all things, he created humankind. He created a person in the form of Adam and Eve. Why am I saying a person? God says, in the image of God, he created them, he and she, male and female, which means the gospel of Jesus was supposed to have been preached from the beginning, or rather, God preached the gospel from the beginning. And what I'm doing is not new. Whatever other pastors are doing is not new. The gospel had been preached from the creation. From verse number 26 of Genesis, the Bible records that we see God saying, let us make man, let us reach to man, let us preach to man, let us teach man, let us go to man. And once God said that, the only thing that he had to do was to give us his image. Let us say his image.
His image.
When God was preaching the first message of go and spread, he would preach it to one person. That was Adam. But after Adam had been created, he gave him a wife called Eve. And what did he do after that? He went to a point where he said, be fruitful and multiply. He was not saying go and get a lot of babies. He was saying, go and multiply my image in the world. And this is where we are today. The image of God must be multiplied. That's the reason why the topic for today is called the gospel. Let us say the gospel of us.
The gospel.
We are not doing anything new according to God. Whatever we are doing is just a takeover from what God had started. Each and every pastor who is preaching the message of Jesus Christ himself is not starting anything new. As pastors, we go to a point sometimes of saying, I'm coming with something new this year. There's nothing that shocks God or takes God by an element of surprise, because God was the first one to preach the gospel. And he could not preach the gospel to himself. He had to create people. He had to create us. Amen.
Amen.
Now, he says in the book of Genesis chapter number 1, verse 26. Number 1, he said, let us make a person or a man in our image. Once you make something in your image, you need to communicate with it. You need to communicate with that person. Once you give birth to a baby, you need to talk, to communicate, to converse, to commune, to mix with that person. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God did that from the beginning. The message was passed. What did he say? He said, be fruitful and multiply. Apart from that, he blessed us. Which means that another form of teaching the gospel is to speak good about other people's lives. Is to speak the message of hope on top of other people, on the lives of other people. And this is what the gospel is all about. Listen to me. The gospel is not the gospel if it focuses on things. It is the gospel if it focuses on a person. Let us say a person.
A person.
Man. Let us say a man.
A man.
Once God says, go and teach, in the book of Matthew chapter 28, from verse number 19, he says, go ye. It is not the gospel of the Son of Man if It is stationary. I repeat that one. The message or the topic of the day today says the gospel. What does the gospel mean? It means take what I have given you, go to other people, spread it out to them, make them understand that which you have understood based on who I am. Hallelujah. I repeat, once we say the gospel, we are actually saying, take what I have given you, that which you have received. That's the reason why even Peter and John could not give the lame man in Acts chapter number 3 anything. They could only give what they had, what they had received. They only gave the gospel to the man, and the man stood up and walked. Why? You only give what you have been given or what you have received. That is what we call the gospel. These people had now received the message from Jesus that go ye, go to the world, go to the people, teach them. This is what Jesus said. He did not say shout at them. He just said teach them. When you teach, you don't shout. You pass out instructions correctly. You go and spell it. Now, let us look at this. The gospel is not the gospel if there are no people. I want to repeat that one. It is not the gospel if it doesn't focus on people. So now, in the year 2021, we are going to focus mainly on people. Let us say people.
People.
We're going to spend money on people. We're going to spend time and effort on people, because the gospel of Jesus is not about eating and celebrating. It is about the lives of people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And today I'm coming with a message that says the gospel. Jesus said, you cannot teach what I did not give you. The gospel is not the gospel if the owner of the message is not part of it. It is not good news if the one who has got good news did not give you anything. That's the reason why Jesus had to spend 3.5 years with his disciples, so that they could take the message, they could absorb the message, they could digest the message, they could even speak the message. That's the reason why in the book of Luke chapter number 10, Jesus sent them out to go and pass the message. They had to go and spell the message. And when they came back, they were so happy. After taking the message from the owner of the message, what do you have to do? You need to run with it. And the results will make you a better person. That's the reason why when they came back, they said, Jesus, no, we went so well. Everything went very well. Even demons listened to us. Even spirits were cast out. People were laid hands upon and they were healed. Why? They had taken the message, the good news from the giver of good news. So you cannot go out and preach the message without the owner of the message.
Amen.
The owner of the message is the gospel himself. It's Jesus Christ. He's the good news the world has ever received. Jesus is the biggest gift that we have never received. Not even a single person's birthday is celebrated just like Jesus' birthday. In South Africa, we celebrate Mandela's birthday, but it is not coming even a fraction closer to the birth of Jesus Christ. Why? He was a gift as a child. He is the master now. He's the owner of the message. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I wish you can go back to the gospel. I wish you can go back to the owner of the good news. I wish you can go back to the creator of all things. To preach the gospel, what do you need? You need the message from the owner of the message. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, go ye, therefore, and teach all nations. Listen to me. The gospel is not about people only. It is also about each and every person. It says all nations, not South Africans only. Not people in Johannesburg only. We need to go to KZN and preach the gospel. We need to go to Northwest and preach the gospel, because it is for all people, for all nations. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I wish you can take the gospel. The world today, the church today, pastors today are filled with things which are not the good news. But may today mark the beginning of what? Of the gospel of Jesus. We take the message, then we run with it. You will not preach to people what you did not receive. If you are not born again, don't even try to preach about Jesus. If you are not filled by the Holy Ghost, if you don't have the power of the Holy Ghost, don't stand up and preach against demons, because they will embarrass you. The only time you can stand up and preach the message of hope to people is when you had started by what? By receiving Christ Himself. People who are born again, doesn't matter whether you are a church member or you are a pastor or an usher, you can stand up and declare the good news, because you need to announce. Now, the biggest problem in the church is we feel like we are the ones who are preaching to the people. Once you accept Jesus, you are carrying His message. When you open your mouth, the utterance of the gospel shall come out. It's not us preaching, it's Jesus speaking. It's the gospel talking. May the gospel start to talk from today in your life, so that you cannot be quiet. People who have got Jesus cannot keep quiet. You can't keep quiet with Jesus. People who have got Jesus in their lives have got something to talk about. The Bible says, he who has the Son has got a testimony. You don't have to announce anything. You better speak one testimony based on what the owner of the testimony did for you. You can preach that message for the rest of your life. If God has healed you from any form of sickness, you need to stand up and say, my gospel is God is the healer. Don't preach another thing that you did not experience. The gospel is based on experiencing things, encountering things, having a physical encounter, spiritual encounter, emotional connection with Jesus. Then you can go and preach it. That's the reason why those people who were called the disciples were ready to die for the gospel. You are not ready to die for the gospel if you don't start in Jesus. These people sacrificed their bodies and their families. Why? They were carrying the gospel. People who are carrying the gospel cannot stay in their house when God wants them somewhere. The gospel means go. Okay, take it, go, and spell it out for people. And to the people. If you're talking about Jesus, spell Him out. Just say to them, even if you don't understand what I'm talking about, if you can call on J-E-S-U-S-C-H-R-I-S-T, your answer is coming. Why? You need to go and spell it. Pronounce it. Let them know how to apply it. Let them know how to live it. That is to preach the gospel. You are not preaching the gospel if people can't spell what you are preaching about. If people can't talk about what you would have taught them, it's not the gospel. The gospel means you teach them, you ground them, you make them have roots of the gospel, you make them have an image of the Father. You made them go according to the blessings of the Father. You made them live within the commandments of the Father. You made them live their lives within the precepts of the Father. That is their gospel. The gospel is not about eating and celebrating women. It's not about being famous. It's about telling the people who Christ Jesus is. May we go all out and tell the people at what place. In our homes, let them know that there is Jesus who can save. If they don't know how to spell salvation, spell don't teach them. That's the reason why even God told Moses to go and tell the children of Israel to write these laws even on their foreheads, even on their palms, and their wrists, even on their doorposts, because they had to spell it. Nowadays, churches are full of people who know only one thing, miracles. They don't know the God of miracles. In this church, we need to know the God of miracles so that we can understand the miracles is working in us. You will not preach about a miracle if you don't receive one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How can I conclude my message? To go and spell doesn't mean to shout or to teach so hard, please. Means to go and announce. It's not your duty to change people. A lot of pastors are trying so hard. They're even coming with magic in the church nowadays. Why? Because they want to convince people. It is not the gospel if you convince the people. You just announce. This is a mistake Jonah had. God said, go and tell them. Go and announce. Go and inform them. He did not say, go and change them. The gospel is about announcing who Jesus is. Whatever I must be doing as a pastor, at the end of the message, people must see Jesus, must know Jesus, not the pastor. It is a miracle that are going to be performed. They must not be given as an accolade to the pastor, but to the owner of the miracles. Your breakthrough is not in the pastor, it's in the gospel, Jesus himself. If you spell Jesus correctly, according to the situations of the people, people shall receive Jesus. And he said, those ones who shall believe, baptize them. Baptize them. What does that mean? It means kill the old person in them. Allow the new man to live in them. So that the scripture that says, if any man is in Christ, in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, if any man is in Christ, a new creation. Once we say we teach you, we are actually saying we are praising who sent us, number one. Number two, we are rebuking the wrongs in the image of God. And once we do that, we are disciplining. We need to discipline in the church. Nowadays, church, it's wonky wonky. Why? People go to church with things and come back with things. The church must teach, must also rebuke, must also discipline. That is the gospel. Jesus had to call Simon Peter, you devil. He was rebuking him. He was disciplining him because he did not have faith. So we need to understand when we say we are going out to preach the gospel, we are also meaning to discipline. We are going to discipline people in the church. Those who are out of order must be given a vaccine to stay and take a break until they recuperate spiritually and come back strong. Those ones who are not doing anything but sitting on properties must be told to sit down until their minds are made up to serve God. Those ones who are working in front must be told that you need to be holy. We are disciplining people. Church is for holy people. You cannot fear God if you don't have holiness in you. We need to fear God. This is the gospel that Jesus is saying we must preach. He says, go to all nations, baptize them, kill the old man in them. All things must die. You must allow new things that start in Christ. New things, times of refreshing, start only in Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They don't start in pastors or the name of the church. They start in Christ. Once you start in Christ, you have started with a good thing. A new chapter, it's starting. Look at this. He says in verse number 20, teaching them
Jesus must teach you who is human. To observe. What is to observe? To take into account every day what the Lord said you must do. If you don't do what God says you must do, we need to come in and teach you that this is what the Lord wants from you, because that is their gospel. It's not their church. Because churches can teach people different things. Some churches are teaching people how to take other people's wives. Some churches are stealing from other people. They steal your money. They hypnotize you and take all your money. This is what the churches can do. But if you have got the gospel, you have got the teachings of goodwill from Christ Jesus. You understand the scriptures. You do the scriptures. You know how to have the discerning spirit. You can discern. You are observing all, not some, all things. Whatsoever I have commanded you, I said the message is not the message, it's not the gospel, if you did not receive from the commander, Jesus. He says, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And when we do all those things, when we observe all those commandments, the Bible says, I am with you. Which means if we don't preach the gospel of Jesus, he's not with us. Whoever is preaching anything called the gospel but is not focusing on Jesus, that thing is done by a person alone. But every time you do the things of God, you preach the gospel, Jesus himself, God is with you. God becomes Emmanuel to you. God becomes Yahweh Shammah to you. Because he is there where people have got his commandments. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's not saying, I'll be with you now only. He says, and I'll be with you until the end of the earth, of the world, of the times. Now, the last verse is Acts chapter number 1. Look at this. Acts chapter number 1, verse number 8 says, but ye shall receive power after. You cannot receive power if you are still doing it in your own means, in your own powers, in your own understanding, in your own ability. You will receive power after I will have descended and landed and rested upon you. Which means you cannot do the things of God. You don't have the message of the gospel without the Holy Spirit. You can't preach without the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit. After this, you shall be my witness. A witness does not say things from the blue. A witness says things just like they happened. That's the reason why in each and every case, they need two or three witnesses. Because witnesses must say what they have seen, what they have received, what they have experienced. So the gospel preachers must be the people who are having a witness. They must have seen, they must have touched, they must have heard, they must have experienced the gospel of Jesus himself. And after that, with your witness, with your testimony, you will never keep quiet, because you will have to tell people what you have seen. And guess what? This is what preachers don't say when they are preaching about this verse. When you have a witness, you vindicate somebody. You save somebody from destruction. The world is judging us. Why do we have to preach the gospel? We preach the gospel because the world is judging the people unto destruction. But when you say, I have seen Jesus, I have experienced Jesus, I have had Jesus, I be touched by Jesus, you'll be telling them that this is the true gospel that saves you, and you can be taken out from this problem. Because you vindicate, you declare them innocent. They walk free. They become new. They are saved. They are incorporated in the house of God. Once you preach the gospel, you must preach the gospel knowing that somebody must live through your gospel. Whatever you say must save somebody. It can be from ignorance, from sinful nature, from unholy living, from unrighteousness, from any form of evil and wickedness. When we preach the gospel, we are actually saying, declare this man free. This is what Jesus came to do. He came to tell the world that even if your sins are as red as scarlet, because I have come, they shall be white as snow. That is the gospel. The gospel does not start on money, it starts on souls. If you start on money as a preacher of the word of God, that is not the gospel, you are all alone. The gospel of Jesus vindicates somebody. It declares Matemula free. It declares Matemula darkness. It declares Matemula sinless. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ that we're preaching about today. And I wanted to preach this gospel. Now, let us understand that the gospel is not the gospel if it is not about people, by the people, and for the people. It's not the gospel, please, if it's not about people, by people, and for people. Jesus lived his life doing good to people. Nowadays, there are witches in the church. I heard one pastor saying, this man burnt my oil on a Sunday, but on a Monday I had killed him. That is not the good news. If you call that the good news in your church, it's not the good news according to this. Good news gives life. It declares a wrong person good and correct. It declares a sinner a saint. I wish you could take this message. If you are the preacher of the word of God, if your preaching is not about their message, Jesus, stop it and start afresh. We don't preach to be seen. We don't preach to be known. We don't preach to be famous. If you want to be famous, go and become an actor or actress. Go and become a singer. But in the things of God, we focus on people. We focus on the lives of people. May God bless you today. May God translate our minds.
Amen.
Into the people who are carrying the gospel. People who are carrying the gospel, wherever they go, are ready to die in order to give people life also. That's the reason why Jesus was ready to sacrifice his life. He was killing the enemies.
Amen.
People who are carrying the good news are ready to die. They're not scared of dying for the gospel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm closing this. And I want us to go back home, but look at this. It says, you shall be my witnesses unto me. If the glory does not go back to God, it's not a preaching of the gospel. The glory should go back to
God,
the Creator, Jesus Himself. He says, you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, start at home, and all Judea, then in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Those who are staying in KZN will understand this. The uttermost part of the earth. When you go to KwaZulu-Natal, you go to Tongat, Verula, you go to Empame, you go to some parts of St. Lucia, Mande, all those areas, going towards, the White Coast. What is happening there? That is where the earth ends. is for each and every person. May this gospel reach the people who are watching at home until they convert and come back to Christ. May this gospel change the preachers of the word of God. Then we start in Jesus. It must be because of Jesus and about Jesus. It is not the gospel if it is about your church. It is about your church name. It is about your pastor, your prophet, your bishop, your apostle, your teacher of the word, your evangelist. It is not the gospel. The gospel is about Jesus. There are so many people who are ready to defend pastors than to defend the gospel. Be ready to defend the gospel at all times by living right and preaching the message of Jesus himself. Let us stand up on our feet. We are going to pray. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have come to the end of the preaching of the word of God today. And I want us to understand that it is not the gospel until it starts with Jesus and focuses on people. It must focus on people, not on things, not on material stuff, not on cars and houses, not on clothes that you are wearing, but it must start and end in Jesus. That is the gospel of Jesus Christ. I want us to pray. We are done with the preacher. May God bless you. And see you next time.